everyone, it's Flo from FertilitiesAndMore.com, and today's video is a makeup tutorial. I am making this look. As you can see, it's more a romantic look, and I think this could be perfect for a bridal makeup tutorial. And yeah, everything is about the eyes. As you can notice, it's like a cat eye effect. I did that with a liquid eyeliner. When you close your eyes like this, it's very thick, but when you open your eyes, it creates the illusion of a cat eye, and it's really crisp and clean, and I really like it. For this look, I also use false lashes because for this kind of day, you want to be more feminine, to open up your eyes and to create the illusion of a deer eye, you know, something very sweet and feminine. And I think false lashes are very great for that. And I also made pink lips because it's very subtle, very feminine. And on top of my lipstick, I add a little bit of gloss because I think this is the last feminine touch. And also, I work a lot on my skin to have the perfect complexion. So I hope you will like this look, and let's start. To start, I always moisturize my skin, so I am using two different types of moisturizer, one of on my T-zone and one other to moisturize my dry cheeks. And I think it's really important to moisturize your skin and to prep your skin before any makeup application. And now I'm using a primer because also I don't want to have shiny face on my T-zone during this special day. And now I am using my current favorite foundation on all over the face like this. I like to apply that on the middle of the face, and I spread out everything with my brush. And I think it's better because it doesn't create any transition between your face, your chin, and your neck. And I think it blends very well like this, and it's more natural. And I like to use this big brush because it's so much more faster at the same time. And now I'm using another foundation, but this one is a full coverage foundation with this little brush that I love, and also my fingers. But yeah, I applied that to cover some rednesses here and there, and I think it's important because I have always rednesses around the nose, and also a little bit on my chin where I have some scars also. And here also, yeah, I have lots of things going on my face. And here to cover a little bit my freckles. And yeah, I have some imperfection on my forehead too. And yeah, I think after that, that's it. And here and there. And I love this foundation because it really helps me to cover all the imperfections that I want to show too much. Next, I'm using a face powder, and it's only to mattify a little bit and to set the makeup. And yeah, I apply that on all over the face, and especially on the T area. Next, moving to the contouring, I am using a matte bronzer like this. And I do the fish face like this, and I apply that on all the area I want to be more defined, because as you can see, my face is kind of flat. And yeah, some Asians have very flat face like me, so I think it's really helpful. And here on the chin, it helps me to create a more defined face and to reduce also the roundness of the face. And here I apply some bronzer also onto my cheeks because it also creates like a glowy and a nice sun-kissed effect that I like. Now to finish off with the face, I am applying a little bit of brush here on the apple of the cheeks, and this is a pink shade that I really really love. Yeah, now it's finished and I can move on to the makeup tutorial of the eyes. I always shape my eyebrows first because I think it's a very important step, and it also helps you to draw and to use your eyeshadow because it's like a base, a good repair. And now I apply a base, this is a brown base, all over the lid. And here I like to highlight my brow bone to create more volume. I apply again a little bit of brown color like this. I am using a CanMake quad that I love because it's so pigmented. And I will show you that a little bit later. But this is really, really nice, and I am using an angle brush and another eyeshadow. This is a matte color, and it's just to enlarge the size of the eyes. And it helps me to contour my eyes a little bit more, because as you can see, it's very flat, and the monolith is very flat. Mine is very flat. And here I use a little bit of highlighter here in the corner to open up the look. And now this is the eyeliner, and as you can see, this is a liquid eyeliner. I don't use that too much because I think it's sometimes a little bit tricky to use that, but this one is very nice. I wouldn't recommend that for a reading because it's not a waterproof product, but perhaps for date night it's more appropriate because the probability of crying is less important. But I draw a thick line like this, and as I told you, when I stare in front of the camera, we can't see the line, but or just a little line, very fine, and when I close my eyes, it's very thick. But don't be scared about the thickness, because it's quite discreet in reality. And now I apply a coat of mascara on the top and on the lower lash line. And I really love this mascara because it doesn't create any clump, and I think this is really, really important. Now we have done with the first eye, and we can move on to the second. And I explain you again the steps. I apply a base on the eye like this. This is a brownish eyeshadow, creates more depth definition, and with the pencil brush and an angle brush, I come back onto the lower lash line and create a junction, and I join the top and the lower lash line like this, and it creates the illusion of a shadow and creates the illusion of a bigger eye. And I apply a little bit of highlighter like this, because my monolith is so flat, and I like to apply a little bit of highlighter in the corner to open up the eye. And after that, this is the next step, and this is the eyeliner. So I always create the line from the middle like this, and I join the corners like this from the inner corner, and I create in the inner outer corner like a wing. And I join everything like this, and I think it's very, very easy. So don't be afraid to create something more dramatic than usual, because you want to stand up a little bit, stand out. And I think it's really, really pretty. It creates like a vintage effect also, like a 60 look at the same time, and I think it's really pretty. And of course, I apply a little bit of mascara as usual. It's also to open up the eyes, because the eyes are always so much more pretty like this. And after the mascara, I apply some false lashes this time, and these are semi lashes because it's more natural. As you can see, I put glue everywhere, but don't be scared about that, because when it dries, it becomes translucent. And you'll see after that, I apply again a little bit of eyeliner to cover any mistakes, or because we don't want to see any glue or stuff like that on your eye. But you'll see it's very, very easy to apply false lashes. And I like to use again a coat of mascara to blend that and to blend the natural and the false lashes together. And I apply a little bit of eyeliner like this. And now the eyes are done, and as you can see, it creates a cat eye effect. It's quite natural, it's quite subtle, and I think the result is really pretty. Now my lashes are bigger, my eyes are bigger, so I think I'm pretty pleased with the look. And now we are done with the eyes and also with the complexion. I can move on to the lipstick, and I'm only using a sample that I got from Lancome, and this is Rouge in Love. I love the shade because it's so feminine, so girly, so cute. It's a pink color with a little bit of orange, and now I apply on top of that a little bit of gloss, and this is also from CanMake, and I love this gloss because it's so moisturizing and the color payoff is awesome. And now this is the complete look. And yeah, I think the result is pretty nice. I like the result. I don't know if you like it too, but yeah, I like it. I think it's really feminine and cute. So this is a complete look, and as you can see, it was easy. It was a little bit longer because I had to add some few steps. I think it's important for this day to use a foundation primer because it helps you to reduce the size of the pores, so it creates a very pretty canvas to work with, and also you want your makeup to stay put longer. I think it really helps for that, and primers also helps you to control your sebum, and also eye primers because obviously you want your eyes be perfect for this day. And don't forget waterproof mascara or something water resistant because you may cry for this day. So that's it for today, and I hope you will like this look, and see you next time.